Hi all, and welcome to the video. In this one, it's the Fr00b playthrough number 7. Right then, folks, I've been a little bit busy over the last couple of days. I converted, rather switched my soldier, who's 220, from AR, which is assault rifle, to SMGs. And kind of did it in a bit of a half-assed way, because I started off and then didn't double-check that, he had all the necessary bits. So it turned into an entire day of running around collecting stuff, which would have been the way round to do it to begin with. But never mind. That's what you get for having a bit of a Friday session. Anyway, so back on the Fr00b, and we're going to go and grab a daily mission and the elite mission. Now, we can no longer get the subway, so I'm pretty sure we'll just do the basic mission. Straightforward, please. Goodbye. Nomad camp. Waste prowlers. Ooh, bit of a chain quest here. Now that one, you have to kill quite a few mobs, so we'll try that. Now, I'm pretty sure now that the senior handler is only going to give us the... There we go. Where can you offer me? I'm pretty sure it's going to be temple. It is. Okay, so the prowler mission does take quite a while, because we just open that up. You can see you... Oh no, wrong one. Waste prowler, you've got to kill 5 waste prowlers, 5 scorpions, 5 blood creepers, 5 pixies, 5 hammerheads. The hammerheads can be a bit of a problem, so that might take us a while to get that done. Yes, it might. So, yeah, not a lot in the way of updates. I spent the IP, so we're now looking at complete of over 200 now, and that's without sort of doing much in the way of twinking, etc. So we could definitely get the stuff from the temple, although I'm pretty damn sure that's what I want for this fixer. See this guy? He is wearing... It's probably... Oh, he has got inspect open. There you go. Blackbirds, nice. And of course, grid armor. Mark 4. Awesome. About the best back armor that you can use on one. If you're playing a Fr00b fixer, there's obviously other items like Spin Shadow Web, which are mostly better options for paid fixers. So, I think rather than do the Waste Prowlers, we'll go straight to the temple, but to get there, we've got to do the little quest that I've already got a guide for, and that's in a video I'm going to link up here. But you don't need to watch it, because I'm going to do it now. But this isn't really me doing it as a guide. This is me just rushing through it because I just want to get to the temple and see how our little guy does. Ooh. I always think I'm going to crash when I come here. Kind of annoying. Right, the first person we want is in this little shed next to Enterprise. Always makes me laugh, that. See, he's got this little torch outside. So we need to run in here and speak to this friendly chap here. So you want food? What will I get out of this? And you just say, fine, tell me what to do. I'll do it. Goodbye. And we need to do 2 little tasks for him. So, wind caller's requests. So you need a Bronto burger. And to get it, you need to just nip around the back of here. And there's a rotund Atrox chap eating. And we also need to... more or less, mug a poor old lady. I don't really like, at least I think the Bronto burger part's over here. While the rest of it, no it's not. I couldn't tell because this was still rendering itself in. There's someone we need to speak to, which is an older looking lady. And then the fat chap. Now the older looking lady is usually around the back here. Can see where I am, and I show you this in the guide when we try and find her. Ah, there she is. So, Maddie Cardi. or cowardly, I don't know. And then we're not very nice to her. So we basically verbally mug her, which I don't really like, but she does give us this. Unfortunately, this card with 1 billion credits, you can't turn into credits. It'd be rather nice if you could. I think that would give every character in the game a damn good start, but it'd be massively abused very quickly. People will be creating characters just to go and grab that. Yeah, so we go past Holodeck, I think. Yeah, that's right. That is where we will find our little blue-named NPC with the burger. I think we have to sort of threaten him. There we go. Annoying dude. Looks like Fatty without hair. There we go. Enough lies, hand me your burger. I will count to three. One. Two. Three. There we go. Goodbye. You don't need that burger, mate, trust me. Don't give me it's your hormones. No, it's not. Might be for some people, but it's not for you. Right, and now we run right the way back to our little friend in his garage hut over here. Oh, it seems to be night time when I'm recording. I should pick a different time of day to play. Make it nice and sunny. Alright, wind called the Garrick. I have the Bronto burger and donation to the temple. Alright, so there we go. There's your burger. There's your credit card. Hey, thank you. And we got another level out of it. Awesome. So are we now level... Crikey. It's level 30 already. Alright, let's just do a couple of basics. And now we've completed that quest, we just click on the sign directly behind this guy. IP's going to start... Yep, it's getting much tighter now. Range, but we should probably do that. But I really want to make sure I can improve NCU, because if we improve NCU, then we can get the buffs we need to get a better weapon on. Right, we're here. Don't attack the mobs directly out here. At this level, they will probably kick your bum. Right, okay, let's run in. Now, the first couple of mobs we need to kill in here, I think we'll probably be okay. I don't know how we're going to do on the rest of it, though. But we're sort of playing this to see what happens. The other new nano I got was this, which is the first one in a line of nanos that expand your NCU. So when I cast it, everyone gets 20, and the very top tier one gives something like 500, I think. Now, first on it is acolytes, but to get to the acolytes, we're going to have to deal with some cultists. Yeah, we definitely need a better weapon. Okay, I'm on full death. Maybe if I go... Let's try full ag with them. Okay, not bad considering what level's this mob. 33, so not ridiculously higher than us. Now, what I'd like to do is avoid as many of these cultists as possible, just to see how we do on that. And that's part of the MA attack, which we don't need. I mean, even when you get it, it's not that great. I mean, you outgrow it within 4 or 5 levels of being able to use it. Oh, picked up a cultist. Oh, I hate these ones. Yeah, it doesn't matter how much nano resist you've got, they can nuke you. And they can do it through walls, they can do it, you know, even if you're completely in a different room, they can nuke through the wall and hit you, which is damned annoying.
Oh.
Savix map. Yes, we've got all this drawn out, so I'll drop that over here, I guess, so we can see where we are. Okay, there's an acolyte this way and a faithful. I've picked up another one. Yeah, we're not high enough level really to outrun them. The NPC we want is acolyte there. And there's a faithful guy there, but we don't want him yet. We need to get three of these before we start thinking about that one. Now, on a twinked out tune, we'd get away with this. Nope. Okay, I'm going to try and kill her, even while Orion, the what's-its, attacking us, which is probably a bit suicidal, but never mind. It would probably help if I had my own heal running, wouldn't it? Okay, Inseminator 2 is just going to run right past and screw me over. But never mind. Why should he worry? Not like I've got a twink for in here that could run around and make him look silly. But I'm not going to do that. Actually, let's blitz it. Let's drop aggro. Go full death. And just run through. Might as well, because that guy has run through already. But if we run far enough, we should be just going through the wake of his little run through there while these mobs are resetting and not actually pick any of them up. That's the plan. Okay, so we can get far enough away from them. Yeah, he's doing his daily, sod anyone else. Yeah, normally I'll offer to team people, but not this time. Yeah, so we've made it all that way into the temple, but we haven't had to fight the entire way. But he'd already charged through. Could be he's doing the mission for... You're healing the one I'm fighting, and I have very little damage, so I'm not impressed, you know. Stop healing, are you? It's hard enough as it is without you healing her. Well, thankfully, they're not blood red and destroying us. I think we can handle this, guys. It's just kind of feels very slow. It's just one on me, isn't it? Yeah. Yeah, we're definitely having to use stimpaks quite a bit more. Okay. So we're at the main aggro range, but I suspect the guy who ran through ahead of us is most likely somewhere else now and has already killed these guys. Oh no, we don't want Defender of the Three. No, we don't. Okay, I don't want to train that player there, so... Okay, we're going to have to run again, so... Do the same again. I don't think Defender will follow you all the way down, but that's now a problem. Is how do we get away from Defender of the Three? I don't think they'll come all the way down here. Might as well loot while we're while we are here. Oh. Looking at the map, he's directly ahead. Oh, someone's running in. And looks like they're fighting him, which we don't want to do. So, going this way. It's looking like it's a little busy in here. Yeah, we are definitely going to need to improve this character to sort of function in here. Acolyte, please let me have this one without someone else diving in and out damaging my little froob. It's not very nice, you know. So we're hitting well enough, but we're just not hitting for enough. Yeah, picked up an ad, I thought we might. It's going to be us dying in a minute if we're not careful. Actually, no, let's switch and deal with that nuke guy first. See, even if I do this, the only way I can really beat him is to keep him moving. So if I keep him moving, he can't cast his nano. So he's still casting it. You see what I mean? Now, I could be on the other side of Temple of the Three Winds, and that guy will still land that. Right, I'm going down here. It's a void. Now, we've got a bunch of these on us. At least, they're not melee. I think that was the one we were fighting to begin with, actually. But it's getting a little bit close to the mark here. We're getting a bit beaten up. So at this point, you've got a choice, really. You can struggle along, or you can find someone to help you, which, you know, is obviously an option. God, this guy's grey. We've got greys in here already. Or you can do a bit of twinking on your character, and I think, realistically, that's what we need to do. We need to get a better weapon onto him. Probably in the process, some better weapons. If he was paid, we'd be demolishing these, trust me. The items you can get and everything else, we'd be demolishing them. Right. You're not allowed to... Well, why not? I killed him. So, we have got, so far, I think, one acolyte. So it's not going brilliantly well. We can see directly above us there are, in the main room, there's plenty of mobs everywhere. So, yeah, this is kind of a bit tricky, isn't it? Yeah, I think we need to do a bit more work on this, Gary. I really do. Right, folks, so we've made a bit of progress with our little froob. So upgraded a couple of implants, made them our, well, had them made, or literally made them with an alt. So we've just increased damage output more than anything else. So just made that one, the right arm, and the head, just for a bit of that, and the chest, because none of the implants in the ready-mades were the ones we really wanted to use. And then weapons-wise, I found these. These are quite new. Certainly went around when I started my actual fixer. But you can see there, DPS is a couple of points higher than it was before. So it says bullets. Well, that's good because we has bullets. So it's looking like we're going to be going that way. And also, I went to Steps of Madness with a 220 NT and loaded some, looted some stuff. So we're a bit better prepared to actually go fight in the temple now. So it's nowhere near a major twink. If you remember the level 25 guy, he was, just annihilating everything in his path back at the subway. He was most definitely a real sort of a twink. And yeah, there was a couple of comments about that. But he did send me a message, and it reads thusly. YouTube user Josh P said, "Hi, Slogle Man here. Just wanted to let you know your videos are pretty great." Thanks, mate. Although you got just one thing wrong. I'm 100% Froob player. Never been a paid player in my life. Anyhow, keep up the good videos. So there you go. He came back to us saying basically that. There we go. We've still got our three wins mission running, and basically we were terrible. So yeah, now to keep this weapon on, soldiers did get a new buff, which I managed to grab hold of, which is composite heavy artillery, which gives you 100 to MG SMG for 4 hours. It's pretty epic, really. So we got that running, and Kane managed to hit me for hack and quack, and he will, no matter where you are. Oh yeah, we just click the face. So yeah, if you're in Old Athen and Kane97 is online, most likely you'll suddenly find you've got hack and quack and grid space freedom. Didn't quite have the space for grid space freedom, but he managed to get hack and quack on us, which we're pretty chuffed about. Right, so we still need acolytes. I don't think we got any XP or anything else from the first one, because, well, basically that guy ran in and ninja killed it with a lot more damage than we've got. Now, even with this little bit of upgrading we've been doing, I don't think we're sort of bulletproof. All right, let's try and get acolyte. Okay, with the hack and quack, I think we're probably okay for tanking a few of these, but let's just up our attack speed a bit. We're on full death there, and I don't think we need to be. Okay, a few of them are starting to miss us, which is, that's always a pretty good sign for a fixer. Yeah, we're hitting quite a bit better now. Okay, let's get rid of these cultists. So that's one. Did we get credit for doing it? One more acolyte. Oh. I guess in which case then we must have got the credit for that first one. I didn't notice the message. I thought the other guy totally outdamaged us there. So yeah, that's kind of his now. He's not struggling. We don't want reverends yet, that's for sure. In fact, I'm not even sure we can handle a reverend. Alright. Let's do the same as before, which is basically what most people do, is blitz through all these mobs and go hide someplace. Now, I'm not sure we're actually fast enough for that just yet, but we can certainly try. Okay, there's an MP over there. I don't want to train him, so I'm going to go around the back way here. Hopefully this will clear them off, and then we're going to take the east corridor. I'm still being nuked through a wall, am I? Right, I think we got away from them. Oh, what have we got here? Faithful. We need an acolyte. I'm not sure if there is any more acolytes down in here. I can't actually remember. Yeah, but they're pretty tough acolytes, so yeah, let's head back up. We might have enough room for our rumba. Ah, I didn't think of that. Even better. Yeah, so yeah, an NT said, "I've been watching your vids. You need to mentor you, mate." And I was like, yes. So yeah, they basically sorted us out. And it just meant we just walked behind an NT using volcanic eruption. And utterly destroying everything around us in almost instantaneously. Just going loot up. So we did. Never look a gift horse in the mouth. Okay, seem to manage to grab a few ads here, but okay. Seem to be surviving them at least. Okay. Okay, can we afford to go a bit more on the ag? Seems we can. Yeah, I'm beginning to regret doing this now, in as much that it'd have been much better to have a paid little fixer. It'd have been a bit more fun, because we'd have had a perennium weapon, some HUD units and stuff like that by now, and kicking a bit more damage output than we are doing now, that's for sure. But we said Froob, it's going to stay Froob. And I know half of you, my subscribers, going, he'll cave in, he'll start as Froob, and then he'll switch it. Nope, I already have a 220 fixer. So, yeah. I mean, that said, I did make another shade and played that till 205, even though I already have a 220 shade. It was just for something to sort of show people the game. And that's been quite a popular playthrough there, so I'm quite pleased with that. Right, we want an acolyte. So, oh, he's in range from here. I like this weapon. So the burst recycle's kind of high, but I can live with that. And in case you're wondering, we bought a couple of nanos as well. So I've got only a retool NCU, which will be good. And also suppressor, which gives us a bit more damage. But probably the most shiny one is this one, Reckless Digitization, which we really want to get to. Now, we just dinged off those. So I still want to be raising these base abilities for some slightly better implants. And then we'll do the green evades. Leave nano resist for now, I think. Range weapons. Yeah, we definitely want to be raising that. Specials. Might as well. Oh. Yep, IP getting tighter. Much, much tighter. So nothing left over there for nano skills. Kind of unfortunate. Right, so we now need faithfuls. So if we look down here. Is there not a. Yeah, it seems to think there's a faithful on this side. I thought they were on the other side, I'm totally honest. We don't really want the cloaks. I know a lot of people think the cloaks are great. But yes, it gives you ACs and a bit of health. But the add def is better, I think, for a fixer. Defender of the three is level 41. That might be a bit of a too much of an ask for us. Yeah. No faithfuls around here. So, yeah. There's wind callers and such there. Let's go down the right-hand side. That's probably the way to go. Because there's definitely a little faithful down at the bottom. Well, there was. You see a bunch of Omni characters running around. He's got a cool looking weapon, I'll give him that. Okay, we're definitely doing a bit better by only really spending, you know, maybe a couple of hours just doing a little bit to the character. So upgrade one or two implants, change out the weapon, get a few buffs from people, and yeah, we're actually looking pretty much like we mean it. So yeah, not bad, eh? I think some of the key is NCU and implants early on, generally speaking. Yeah, we don't want a reverend. Can we get past him? Yeah. Okay, I think, yeah, this looks like a... Yeah, kind of a twink team going on there. Right, we got an acolyte there. And then... Sorry. I'll deal with it. Yeah, because you've got basically two people on follow there by the look of it. Following that MP. Because they're just... Well, you can see. They're just following. Right, so looking at the map... Yeah, we're getting towards Guardian. Now, I have got a temple twink I could log to do stuff in here. But is Got down? Got is down. I just want to see if Got's got anything good. See, I think that might be a better deal, I think. So, yeah. Eternal Guardian. I think the MP's dealing with that, by the look of it. Yes, he is. Even though we've got dramatic music... It's not hitting us too hard, actually. At all. But it would probably take us a very long time to get through. There's actual Got. I'm almost sure that would kick our bottom. Looks like he's fighting it through a doorway. Which is fair enough. I've got a little enforcer that can stand toe to toe with that mob and basically destroy it. But I think the only thing he can't solo is the big boss. Ooh, I've got music. Something. Cultist following me. Okay, let's deal with him. And then we need to get back on track and get some faithfuls. I suppose we could go do... There's a couple in the main room, so we're probably better off going there for now. He's not respawned, so yeah. Let's head back up, see if we can find two more faithfuls to play with. Better redo NCU compressor. Otherwise, the hot will stop working or something. Trying to avoid pulling things onto people if I can. Well, there's a faithful. They'll do. Yeah, thanks, mate. Yeah, I really wanted you to do that. Thank you. Yeah, so that's kind of how some people are. You know, just run in and full auto like that. So we're going to have to wait for another spawn. Because, you know, pimped out soldier twink there. Just decided to, you know... Even though you've engaged it, I'm just going to run in and attack it anyway. Thanks. This gimpy little cultist seems determined to have a go. Yeah. Faithful. We could run... It's a long way to run back, though. That's what I'm thinking. We could run all the way back to the start, but I don't know. If we go down the middle, there's Orin the Faithful in the middle area, isn't there? Maybe we should just nip down there, take a look. The Defender of the Three will ignore us. He usually doesn't come much further than there, he says, just before the guy destroys us. Oren, or whatever he's called, he's a Atrox faithful that sort of wanders around this corridor. Thought I could get away with picking that guy up, but oh, not today. Can I stay as close to this wall as I can and avoid getting into aggro range from the others? I can't see the orange guy anywhere. So maybe he's been killed. Oh, great. Grey ones, you're not even worth killing, really, are you? You know, being grey and all. Yeah, one XP for you guys. Oh, don't... Oh... Hate these guys. You know what? Screw you. So he's rooted over there. Let's go this way. Right, there you go. How far away is he? Still managing to hit us there through a wall. No, I can't do that on any character I've got. I can't shoot people through walls. There you go, and again. Where actually is he? See? He's absolutely nowhere to be seen. He's right over there. To the point where he's actually reset. Oh, he resisted. Fair enough. Yeah, count it again. Come on. There we go. Now, see what this guy does. See, he can't hit me from there. The melee ones can't, but that guy that drops nukes, there's the guy we want. Oh, it's not Orin, it's Malachi, the faithful. You'll do. Okay, I'll deal with this one. And then this one just runs in randomly from the side. Thank you very much. Right. So that's him down. We should probably start grabbing some of these rings, although I don't know if I want to replace the adult deaf ones, because they're pretty useful for Fixer. Okay, so we have Defender of the Three up there. Probably Mr. Soldier Twink pegging it around, destroying everything, but... Or he's got bored and finished. Ah, she's back up. I still haven't gone and bought a ingression enhancer. I need to do that. Keep forgetting to. Got one on every other character, but not this one. And it's solely just used for pulling. Hey! Fantastic! Right, I didn't actually know we'd lost XP. But I suppose it's not much to lose at this level. Right, so now it wants us to get Reverence. And I think probably... best place for that is the middle room, seeing as we're solo and can't really handle big scary mobs. So back down to the corridor where we were at, I think is going to be the way to go. Now the belt from Temple of the Three Winds is this one. So max NCU 15, gives you 5 slots, and max nano 17. The ones we got for free are like this, so... still gives you 5 slots, but you get 100 HP, but only 12 NCU. So I think that belt with the extra health is good. The NCUs here, though, are only 20 NCU. Oh, God, here he is. What's he called? Yeah, that's the guy. So, Temple Twink, Ardmore, don't care what anyone else is doing. I'm just going to blitz through. Screw you. I think that's his basic. Yeah, there he goes. You know, we just peaceably want to try and, you know, find some reverence. I don't think we've got any in here. We've got Exarchs, Windcallers, they're next. Oh, well, maybe when he's finished. You know, there might be some mobs left for other people to kill. Probably not, but temple twinks are a thing. Be some AFK person sat somewhere inside the temple getting the mission update. You know, so nice for them, I guess. Oh, I think Reverend we saw, yeah, down the main area, which is this way, the east. This takes you down to the main boss room. And we've got a random mob running around there. Probably someone fighting this guy. Yeah, there is. Roller monkey. Medic. I'm gonna be there all day. Oh well. Oh, okay, fair enough. Now, there was a reverend through this door. No, he's not there. So, we'll deal with it. Really? Where the hell is that nuke coming from? Oh, there you are. I absolutely think these guys need some attention. I'm going to be on this guy. There you go. So there's that cultist that was fighting us is that far away. He's down there and into the next room, and yet he can still nuke us. It's ridiculous. No player could ever do that. Just would not happen. Well, if you did, you'd be exploiting, that's for sure. And another twink. Don't people do anything for themselves anymore? Another twink running through. Straight to the got room. You know, straight past anyone who's busy fighting. Doesn't matter if it pulls a dozen mobs behind them and leaves them on that person. No, that doesn't matter. That's just how it is in the temple. Right, so after all that, the guy we want isn't here. The hell's hitting me now? Oh god, the acolyte's respawned. See, the problem is our damage is so low that effectively we are pretty much can't keep on top of the respawn as a fruit. If we were a pay player, we'd be sort of one-shotting these guys almost. Is that a... Probably got this guy into a quality 100 perennium weapon, which would have made pretty big holes in these guys pretty fast. That was the guy we wanted and didn't get, so yeah. Someone's farming for the Guardian tank armor. You won't get it unless you spawn a higher level. Got Reverend Hyman. He looks tough. How tough is he? 45. I think we can take him, you know. Let's go over to this corner here. Thank you. Well, we could take him a lot quicker if the other cultists would stop healing him. Little Omni team blasting past here. Okay, so that's one Reverend down. But we're nowhere near these other guys. Nowhere near. Right, so put a bit more in there, but then I really need to start investing into here if I want to start using some better nanos like that one, which gives us even more NCU. Well, that is Matter Met. We're there. Sense Imp. Yeah, need more in Sense Imp. Time Space, not so far off. The one I'm really interested in, of course, is Meep. But I think we're a bit ways off from that. So, Psycho Mod. And, yeah. See what I mean? There's very little IP to play with now at this level. Oh, Mr. Reverend. Yes, he's dropping. See, you actually get some pretty decent weapons in Temple of the Three Winds, unless you're ranged, and then there's basically none. Which is a bit of a shame, really. Okay, you need to be very, very careful here, as we're entering into the big main chamber, which is up here. It looks like it's pretty much cleared out. And they're also clearing out the boss a few times by the look of it. Yeah, you can almost always get a Stilgen Desolator from here. We'll take the ring out of blame. And then Barrow Strength. Oh, inventory full. I'll get rid of my old brain implant. And grab that. I need to make more room, so I'm going to have to delete things. There's MA stuff. Already got. That could be useful. And the night one we've got. Don't think we can get Barrow Flesh on just yet. Okay, we've got another Reverend here. Seems open. No one seems to be trying to kill him, so she'll have a go at this guy. Got a feeling something else is hitting me there, but I'm not sure what. No, I think we're okay. This guy's kind of an MA mob. There we go, one more Reverend. Can't see one. Up there, Shadowfall. Yeah, some agent armor. Kind of looks cool. I don't know if it's actually any use, though. Oh, Muriel the Faithful. That's actually the Reverend we want. Okay. Oh. Not sure where he just vanished to. It's like he's attacking somebody over there. And then miraculously walked over here for some whatever reason. Is that guy even... he's not even fighting him. Maybe he's AFK or he's crashed. Didn't look like he was having too much of a problem with him, but he was kind of ignoring him then, so my guess is he's not actually there. We got that, and that's going to be fun to get that on. But it does give some nice little buffs at this lower level sort of stuff. Thank you. Not bad. Okay, so now we want wind callers. There are some in that other room, but that soldier twink guy was in there, wasn't he? And he's probably not fond of sharing. In fact, I'll almost guarantee not fond of sharing. These two are doing pretty damn well up there. I'm staying down here, because if you go up there, that guy does have AoE attacks, and you can wind up in a world of hurt that you had no intention of getting involved in. Yeah, he's got binded blackbirds, I think. Yeah, nice setup. Mortig. Oh, he's got the beamers. Yeah, they're pretty awesome. Oh, well. We're not paid, so we can't have those. Wind callers do spawn here, so might be a good idea just to sort of hang here rather than try and going down to that other room, because I think if we go down to the centre room, if the other guy's there, we're not going to have a lot of fun. So Kerrin's automatic grinder, DPS 6 to 35, and this one was 9 to 49, so it's not a massive difference really. I just like the idea of a suppressor. Also, it says at the bottom here, this suppressor is a twin-barrel submachine gun. It fires many, many rounds per second. This weapon can be upgraded further. It is possible to balance the weapon so it fits you perfectly. Now, I remember the 00 weapons would do that, but I can't seem to find any info on these new type of weapons. Whether they use the same kit and times five the mechanical engineering to do it. So I'm going to look into that, and if that's the case, then I'll see what this is like once it's upgraded. Seem to be managing this one okay, actually. I think largely down to Kane's hack and quack. What level are these? 48 and we're level 32. So it's not a massive thing, but it feels pretty tough on a frew, I can tell you now. Oh, take the red berry wine. That's worth 25k really. So that's pretty decent looking armour really. Okay, I think we're gonna get the acolyte, or is that just running off in a random direction? After wind callers, I think it's Exarchs, and I'm not sure we can handle the Exarchs up on the main platform, because they're quite a bit higher than we are, and if we mess up the pull, we're going to be in a world of pain. If we get the boss, we're pretty much jiggered. Someone there bringing all their little alts into the guild. That's what we like. We like them all under one roof. Hey, Muriel's going to give me a hard time. Let's get out of sight of Muriel. Stop walking around, Muriel. No, there she goes. Platinum. Ooh, that might be worth putting on, actually. Some AC, some NCU versus... What did these give? Our def one. No, I think it's time to... swap over. Yes, I do. I think our def one just really isn't a thing. I need another wind caller. I'm pretty sure the wind callers, looking at this handy map, actually. Yeah, there's the two guys here, are the only ones we'll get. So if we kind of hang back, actually, can we get up there without being attacked? There's one Exarch up there, but there's the corpses up there. I'm really curious to see if there's anything good on it. They just left it. Okay, already got the barrow strength. sure what these guys were after. Doesn't seem like they got it. Don't want to be up here for too long. No, we don't. Now, we get Exarch Robe. Maybe that's what they're doing, farming Exarch Robes. Could be. Could be that. They've been busy, though, look. It's like 3 kills. It's all gone very quiet in the temple. Nobody's fighting anything. That or my sound card has stopped working. We've got 20 minutes left on the RRFE. So we could really do with those. Maybe we should. Maybe we should blitz our way, if we can, to that other room. There's definitely some wind callers in there, unless that guy is still in there, killing many, many things. Yeah, I can't see any players up ahead of me. Maybe one there, but these should be nipping back by then. I don't think he's going to have a problem with the ads. He was one of the guys that was killing the main boss. So, yeah, he's not going to struggle with those. But it could just be that's a ghost. And by ghost, I mean the guy's actually left the place. But my client is trying to tell me that he's still there, running up against the wall, when in fact he's not. Now, if it was Counter-Strike, he'd be an easy kill. But it's not Counter-Strike. It's Anarchy Online. Sibby hit. Oh, I don't think we're going to get much of a look in here. Looking at the damage I can see in my spam window. Looks like someone on here owning everything in the room with very high damage output. Oh, well, it's the two guys from the main temple room, so we might as well run back there. Because we're not going to get anything in here, unfortunately. No chance, not with those two. They were doing a pretty solid job on the main boss, and he is problematic. Something's nuking me, even though I can't even see where it is on the map, and it's still nuking me. I hate those guys in this instance. They are just total pain in the bum. Hopefully none of these gots are actually alive. No. Hopefully not. Ooh, might have a reverend on our tail. Got you. We should have stayed in here. We should have stayed in here. Oh my god. Oh my god. This was a bad plan. Okay. Start weakest and work our way down, I guess. And hope for the best. Yeah, we should have just stayed. Now we've got to deal with all these guys. Which I didn't want to have to do. Well, if we die, we die, I think. But we seem to be holding up pretty well. Thanks to Hack and Quack, I think. And, of course, a bit of RRFE. So we've got 15 minutes of that left. So need to sort of think about that, I guess. Well, we got a ding. So if we die, we're not going to lose a ton of IP. Let's do Sense Agility. We'll have to do intelligence for the nano skills. And yeah, it's going to be a while. And someone asked, are you clicking your arm? Yes, but not in the middle of a fight. I sort of do it after the fact. Unless I sort of think, oh, you know, I'll click that and I'll get that extra 1 point in nano skill from there, you know. could have done that while we were waiting, but I think I'm out of inventory space again. I need to invest into some more bags, I would say. Wind caller. I think it is only one we need now. See, we're sort of going pretty slow against this guy. We can handle his damage, it just takes a... seems to feels like a very long time in killing him. Especially when you've got sort of no specials to play with. Well, apart from Burst, which is on a about 30-second timer at the minute. So, Exarchs. We're going to have no hope of getting the Exarchs in. Oh, they've come back in this room now. And they're kicking the arse out of that guy. But we've probably got no chance. I'll just try a one hit. And see if we can get him down to here. See if we can handle him. Oh, come on, Sibby from Unity. You're just a kill stealer, aren't you? Clearly I'm fighting the guy. And it's like, no, I'm taking him. It's not very helpful. You know, it's sort of like you're fighting the big guy, but you want these guys as well. And it's kind of a bit unfair. You know, you were in the other room, so I came back here, and now I come back here, and you're in there. I mean, you're not even fighting that guy, and you'll probably end up killing him. I just want the three kills, that's all I want, and to see if I can actually do it. See, look, he's right, I'm going to fight him as well, even though that's an ad. He's just going to have a go over there. I don't want the cloak if you're farming cloaks, for God's sake. Arr. I won't get a you need to kill countdown either for this at this rate. So just do far too little damage against him. And you sat here quietly, you know, chopping away, hitting this guy. As he is now, he's not even going to come close to doing any kind of out-damaging these guys at all. See, my crit is less than their regular damage. Oh, I actually got credit for killing that one, which is all I wanted to do. Not really in the market for killing that boss or looting up tons of stuff. See, another decent melee weapons for every class. Nothing for ranged. I think we got that, didn't we? Not sure. Hard to know now. Don't need that. You already have. Okay. See there, a ring you can use to dot things. Right, well, maybe. Let's get out of this room. And try the other Exarchs, which are lower level. But it looks like they're kind of killing the boss and destroying the Exarchs as well. Never seen so much activity in such a lobey sort of place. Kind of nuts, really. I'm half tempted to log my level 60 enforcer. Because he can kill almost everything in here. I don't think he's as good as those two that were up there. Sibian, whatever his friend was, killing the main boss. But they're he's respectably good, I would say. Someone running around with a lot of mobs running after them. Can you still jump up on here? Because you used to be able to. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, if you didn't know that trick, it does work. It'll reset these guys. More or less. And I think we've managed to get ourselves stuck because I can't jump off. Not sure what weapon he's got. I think it's a Kearns. Oh well, let's fight some. He looks very familiar, that. Cedric, a Froob above the rest. So that'll be a level 54. Fixer. They're doing wind callers. Don't need them. I need the Exarchs. And someone else just ran in the back to go and attack the big mob in this room. It's kind of like... It's just like every man for himself in here, it really is. You were on the wind caller, but no, you had to go and kill the Exarch. You had to take that off me, didn't you? What level is he? Yeah, fully paid up, sub. I'll just screw your fun. Screw what you're trying to do. I want it. Well, at least someone's being friendly. He did. Basically, just say... Hi, Cal. So I'll sort of say, hey. But now he's run over there and fighting with that guy who just screwed me out of an Exarch. Did like a whole little team there. Said hello, but we'll still come storming in and kill steal from you anyway. Yeah, thanks. That's really friendly. So basically, this looks like it's Twink's day out at the temple. Well, the old saying is, if you can't beat him... You may as well join them. So, let's see, what GS are we actually in? I think I'm going to bring in a specialist. So what I'm doing now is running in an alt of mine, who's my little level 60 temple twink. Because, well, no one seems to want to be nice. And the old saying is, of course, if you can't beat them, yeah, join them. And this guy's nowhere near as twinked as some people. I mean, he has got these Mortig beaters of anguish and distress, and the Tig beaters are actually really quite nice. Right. So, I'm going to play Cluid now. Someone's charmed the cultists. That's kind of cool, actually. Right, so we're just waiting on the spawn. Like, everyone's fighting over these mobs. It's kind of annoying. Gone away for some reason. I didn't do anything. I haven't attacked anything. I think he just inspected this guy's equipment. So, yeah, he has got one of those Guardian tank armors and some OFAB gear and, yeah, the TIGs. And then, you know, nothing major, just some level 100 implants. So yeah, we are now helping out our little fixer. Nobody's got a face in here. It's all very weird. Oh, Notum Ring of the Three. He should get one of those. I should drop loot for it as well. Blood Leech, it's another dot ring. Yeah, those are unique, those wines, so. So I keep flicking back and forth, and sorry if it's confusing, but. Yeah, see, that's a bit better for him. Add damage, always nice. Because one thing he hasn't got is much damage. Seems like a longer spawn time when you're waiting for it than it probably is. Cultist. And Exarch. Right, I think that's completed the mission on Cloner there. So we'll help these guys out, get rid of their rads, and then help them with this. He's got him to halfway, so I shouldn't be able to pull any real aggro off him now. There we go. They can have the loot. Because we're nice like that. Right, so. He's basically done his job, and I'll, can't remember where he saved, but I'll send him back to Rubicar, and then Lona's got to make his own way out of here, which is, probably going to take a bit longer. can always come back again and maybe get the other NCU types, because they are quite good, to be fair. Oop. Wrong door. And I've still got the Waste Camp Prowler mission to do. It could be a long day. Out of here, and then we've got a hell of a long run back. Because he's Froob, I don't have the recall beacons, and I can honestly say, really did we get used to them. No idea how many tokens I've now got. Have a look. Whoa, look at that. We've actually got a tiny bit on our token board. It's kind of awesome. So basically, we've got to run a very long way south to get back to Deer. Okay, folks. Bye for now.